Hey everyone, today's video is all about fake sweets, and I'm making a couple different ones today, at least two. I think there's two, there might be three, but that's not the point of me telling you. Today's video is about fake sweets, and I'm gonna show you how to make them. I don't know if you can guess which one's the fake one, but we'll see. On this channel, I love to share easy DIYs and budget home decor. And if we haven't met yet, my name is Lisa and this is our gray house. So like I said, this video is about fake sweets and it is a collaboration playlist. Do y'all like peeps? I do. I like the regular flavor. One year, my nieces and I did a video where we tasted different flavors of peeps. Still like the original ones best. I'll link that video up in the cards, whichever side it goes on. But anyway, that's not what this video is about. I'm gonna show you how I made some fake peeps and a fake cake and some other things. But today's hosts for this are
Kiki from Kiki DIYs, Tammy from Happiness Created, and the co-host is Tammy from The Rusted Willow. Now there's a whole bunch of other crafters that you need to check out, so please click on the playlist after watching my video. This video starts off with a visit to Dollar Tree because that is where I will get all of the supplies for today's projects. Dollar Tree carries a lot of cake decorating supplies, and even though I'm not really using them today, I do have some future videos that I will need these for. They have piping bags, different tips, as well as like platters, or maybe they're called like, I don't know, cake holders, but you can put your different projects on those. I have these glasses already in my stash because I have a super cute idea for these. And the glass bowls that they carry are also great pieces to use. And I also bought this mug because I have another idea for a future video using it too. So grab a pack of these styrofoam rounds that you can find in the floral section of Dollar Tree. And after I watched some videos, I made myself a template that fit the styrofoam rounds that I bought. And I cut two ears, and the other piece you could use as a bow tie or something like that, but I just used the ears part. And it's very easy to cut, and I just used a crafting knife to do it. You're also going to need some spackling. Now, I thought about using joint compound instead because it already has like a frosting-like consistency, and maybe I'll use that next time. But for now, we're going to try the spackle. To make the frosting for the cake, take the spackle and combine it with the color paint that you want. And I'm doing a coconut bunny cake, so I'm using white paint. I add some paint, mix it in, and then I add some more as I think it, you know, if I need to make it a like a more frosting-like consistency. And in hindsight, I probably could have used a bit more paint, but for this project, it actually turned out just fine. I needed to attach the bunny ears to the head, so I went to go get some toothpicks, and as you can see, Socks is checking out what I'm making. But I take those toothpicks and I attach the bunny ears, and now it's time to start adding the frosting, and it goes on well. And I do think it could be just a bit smoother, but it worked out fine. And after I add the frosting, I'm gonna add the fake coconut. And because you won't wanna use these items for real food later, you will need a grater. And I tried grating a bar of soap, but it just turned out powdery. It didn't turn out like I was thinking it was going to. So then I took a white wax candle, and all I had was a votive candle, but it works. And I'm just grating the candle to make fake coconut. And then I start sprinkling it on and pressing down the coconut onto the frosting. And it worked really well. And it was really very easy to do, and it looks real, y'all. I did add some dark brown frosting, kind of actually turned out gray. That was for the eyes and the nose. And I'm looking at this, y'all, and while I see things that I really could improve upon, I wanna say this was so much fun and pretty easy to do. So I'm definitely gonna be trying another video where I can try more ideas. I bought this Model Magic off of Amazon. They do sell some at Dollar Tree, but not usually in white. You can just paint it, and you'll see me do that in a little bit with my piece. And why am I showing you that it's gluten-free? I mean, I don't know. Anyway, also cut out your template. I tried to make mine the same size as the real peeps, but mine was, you know, just a bit larger. Why am I looking at the package so much? I don't know. Pull off some of the model magic and warm it up a bit by stretching it and squeezing it. It's probably an official term for that. Maybe it's like kneading, like you do bread, like kneading bread. But anyway, whatever it's called, do that to it. And oh, I guess I needed some more. Yeah, I was gonna make a couple peeps though. Probably just needed some more model magic. It feels really squishy. And then roll out the model magic, or you could use clay, but the model magic dries spongier than the clay does, so I think it looks more realistic, in my opinion. Then use an X-Acto knife or a kitchen knife or something like that and cut around the pattern. And you may need to use your fingers to smooth down the edges because, you know, you're not actually cutting, kind of like stabbing. And then, and y'all know how I feel about glitter, but sometimes you have to take one for the team. And so, yes, I'm intentionally putting glitter on something. So I painted these in the color Vivid Pink. And as I went along, I sprinkled on glitter to mimic the sugar on peeps. And I added dots for the eyes and for the nose. And here's a side-by-side comparison, and aside from the size and the color being a bit off, you know, I think it looks pretty darn good. And the best thing about this challenge is it really did challenge me to try something different, and I can't wait to make some more fake sweets. And I already have several ideas swirling around in my head, so be sure and stay tuned to my channel for more.
Also, for the record, I threw part of it away, so basically you can follow me for health tips as well. Thank y'all so much for joining me today. I really do appreciate the company while I craft and create, and I hope you enjoyed my attempts at fake baking and making fake sweets. And if you have any tips, tricks, or if you have any favorite creators, leave them in the comments below because I'd love to check them out. And I'll leave some inspo creators in my description box as well. And also, if you want to follow me on social media, like here on YouTube, over on Instagram, on TikTok, Facebook, something like that, my handle is Our Gray House, but just don't follow me in real life though, because that's creepy. Bye.